evening friends, Captain Vijay here. Today we'll be talking about the Swiss cheese model. Have you heard about it? I guess maybe not, maybe. This theory or the model, I'll be discussing it in the slides and also I'll be showing a small video, is basically to help eliminate all the barriers so that the end result does not lead to any accident or any injury. So I've been using this model and theory, and I've been making slides and presentations on board the ships wherever I go, and I find that this is one of the most essential theory. This has been widely used in many of the shore organizations, and it should be very much implemented in our maritime industry as well. And since we are sailors sailing on board ships, definitely we should use this theory or this model on board our ships in the bridge, CCR, as well as the engine room. So let's go ahead and start discussing this slide.
So let's start this slide. Swiss cheese model for use in maritime industry. So what is Swiss cheese theory? It is a beautifully elegant way of illustrating the idea that before any risk can manifest, multiple barriers have to be breached. This applies to both negative and positive risks though. So in maritime industry, we'll be just talking about the negative risk associated with this. So the best way to explain this Swiss cheese theory is with a picture, obviously. So as you can see, this is the accident trajectory. These are the various cheese slices, which are called as the barriers. And for any accident or the consequence to take place, they have to pass through all of the cheese slices. That means all these holes have to be in a line. Now looking at the cheese slices, you can make out, suppose if this hole over here did not exist, then this barrier would have prevented this from going to the other barriers. Now if this hole would not have existed over here, that means this barrier would have prevented the accident or incident to take place. How about the last cheese slice? If this barrier would have prevented the line to pass through, then the entire accident or incident would not have taken place. So this model was initially developed by Mr. James Reason to illustrate how analysis of major accidents and catastrophes tended to reveal multiple smaller failures that allowed a hazard to manifest as a risk. So in his model, each slice of cheese represents a barrier, any one of which is sufficient to prevent a hazard turning into a consequence. So this theory works on the assumption that no single barrier is foolproof. So what he's trying to say is that every single barrier is not foolproof. So any hazard which will turn into consequence, it has to pass through all the barriers. They all have failings or holes, and when the holes are allowed to align, a risk event can manifest as a negative consequence. The interdependent nature and benefits of redundant layers of mitigation associated with the protection in depth principle is illustrated by the Swiss cheese. The Swiss cheese theory may look like a simple illustrative tool, but it has a profound implication for the way we can manage risk. In terms of preventing losses, it is linked to the fundamental idea of protection in depth. What this means for us as risk managers is that when we build risk mitigation plans, the multiple layers of treatment needs to integrate and support each other. It's near certainty that on long enough timeline, every risk treatment will fail or leave vulnerabilities. The trick is to make sure that they don't fail concurrently. That means at the same time. These are the various barriers. Barrier 1, barrier 2, barrier 3, barrier 4, and barrier 5. So we'll play this video. These are the various barriers, total number of 5 barriers. Barrier is effective, no hazard event. So if the hazard stops here at the first barrier, no incident or accident will take place. So we can assume, for example, this barrier 1 is a quality design, barrier 2 is the safety procedures, our SMS system, barrier 3 is the people culture on board, barrier 4 is the personal protective equipment that we use on board, barrier 5 is the various alarms and monitoring system that we have on board. Thank you. So if you see barrier 3, there is inexperience, that is one of the walls, poor knowledge of system, low motivation, time pressure. Now in these people there can be many various factors, you know, human error, as they say, comes to inexperience, poor knowledge of system, low motivation, time pressure, fatigue. How about the quality design? Design error, residual risk, equipment failure, operating outside the design parameters. This is related to any machinery which is operating outside the design parameters. The equipment has failed, design error. So basically, for a risk to take place, a straight line has to pass through all these G slices. I'll just give you a small example for onboard how to apply. So I'll just give you a small example how to apply this onboard. Master is on bridge, navigating in heavy traffic. Duty officer is on bridge. The AB is steering and there is extra lookout. So master alters to port and there's a vessel coming from the port quarter. The duty officer is aware of the vessel coming from port quarter, but he fails to inform the master, assuming that the master must have taken this action and he is aware of the vessel coming from the port quarter as well. He assumes, you know, assumption. And the duty officer and the lookout, who has already informed the duty officer and sees the vessel is being again going and sees the vessel is being altered to port, he also just keeps quiet. So we have barrier number one, barrier number two, master is another third barrier. All right, so we have three barriers in place and all have failed. So what is going to happen? A near miss or a collision or an accident may take place. So what if one of the barrier, you know, would have prevented this from happening? For example, you know, the duty also, if he would have told the master that there is a vessel coming from the port side and we're altering to port, is that okay? And if the master replies, yeah, I know there's a vessel coming from the port side, I'll be just going a little bit and, you know, coming back to starboard. So, okay, the duty also is also clear. But assuming that the master is aware of all the vessels in the vicinity, that is wrong. So that is also, you know, part of the bridge team management. Everybody is a team member. Everybody has to participate. The bridge cannot be run, you know, one man show. Similarly in CCR or in the engine room. Engine room, whenever they are doing a major machinery overhaul, it has to be a teamwork. When they are doing a, doing maneuvering in the engine, it is a full teamwork. They cannot just rely on one person, you know, second engineer or chief engineer, and you know, the machinery will run perfectly. That's not going to happen. Similarly, in CCR, chief officer is in charge, second officer and third officer are very much part of the CCR operations as well. It has to be a team effort. All the barriers should do their role and make sure that the hazardous occurrences does not pass through all the holes in the G slices, and then it results in an end disaster, accident or incident. So hope I was clear in this explanation of the Swiss cheese theory. Check it out online, you know, do some research and try to apply it. In short, whenever you are on the bench or in the engine room or in the CCR, be a part of the team, you know, be a team member, get yourself involved proactively in the discussions and effectively. I'm not saying to challenge master's orders during bridge maneuvering. I'm not saying to challenge his every orders or helm orders when he is on the bridge having the con. Just have a situational awareness, and if you feel something is not right, especially when there is pilot on board, and if you feel something is not right, you speak to the pilot without any fear. It's better to be safe than sorry. So this is Captain Vijay signing off.
Thank you for watching my video.
Subscribe to Papa's channel, hit the bell icon, follow him on Instagram.
Thank you.
Thank you.